Welcome everybody to this little video tutorial about Nero Platinum 2018 trial version. And we want to show you how you can do very easily a video DVD with Nero Video. You will see that you have 30 days of trial with this version, and most of the functions that you will also have in the full product, you can test in this product. So it's almost an unlimited version for 30 days, including burning, which you will like very much, we believe. So let's click on Nero Video. And what I want to do is I want to create a little slideshow, basically, for my grandma. And the slideshow should include photos and videos of my cute little dogs, which my grandma likes a lot, and I want to create a DVD for her. So I have put everything into my PC system already, so I imported all the stuff to my pictures from my smartphone into my PC, and I can just drag and drop the whole folder with my content to the drop zone of Nero Video. And then it will be imported right away into the timeline very quickly with all the images and videos. Here are the videos. These were the outdoor images. These are the indoor images. So basically, I want to cut it down to a sequence where it shows outdoor action and indoor action. And the indoor action is mainly with static images. In order to be able to arrange everything to a nice matching sequence, I will just click on the expand storyboard view, which gives me a perfect overview. And okay, I have the idea that I want to have a sequence of three images followed by a sequence of a video, three images, a video, and so on until the end. So maybe we want to rearrange something, because I think these are some of the nice images for an introduction. Okay, put it there. Then we can use this video as the next asset, and I also can edit it right away in the storyboard view, and I use the mark in and mark out. You see this? It shows mark in, mark out. This is basically the entry point of where the video starts and the out point. This is basically a virtual setting which is saved inside of your project. So I just press play, and I want to start here, then let it run. And I want to stop here. Okay, so it's edited. Then the next sequence, I think I don't like this too much. I think there is a sequence when they are sleeping in their little hut. This could be okay. Delete. Three images is enough. The next sequence with the video is here. Let's put it up. Okay, here, cut it, mark in, okay, let it run, okay, out, okay. Then the next video, no picture sequence, let's see what can we do there. Yes, this is quite nice. This is quite nice, and then we have the final video sequence. Yeah, when the little dog looks into the camera. That's nice. Okay, bye-bye. And out. Oops. So the out point is here. Okay. So that's the final outdoor scene. Then I want to have three further indoor scenes, and I cut away the rest. And these are videos too. But I have a much better way of integrating these as an intro and outro sequence by using one of the great themes. So I can just get rid of these in my project, switch back to my video, and you can see the whole thing looks very nice without any effect so far. No transitions, nothing. No music, basically a clean, if you want, rough cut. Now, the easiest way to really make this become an outstanding movie is using the movie themes. And you have a lot of different movie themes here, as you can see, many, many different topics, anything you like. And the latest ones that you might want to try especially are the My Day themes. So basically these are typical themes that you have in your everyday life, and because the dogs are part of my everyday life now, I want to use a My Day theme. And here maybe I want to try this one, which is like a kind of photo album kind of theme. You see, it gives you music, automatic. It gives you an animated intro sequence, and in this intro sequence I can easily insert my videos, which I, oops, that's not all, just one, okay. And then it will be automatically integrated into the animation, which is really cool. And I can also change the title easily. Just say My Dogs, for example, and maybe change the color to yellow, okay, and it will fit into this one. I can also maybe add some shadow, it will be nicer, okay, and then you see it looks very nice. And if we look into how the whole template is set with effects and so on, you can see that we have a number of transitions, we have pan and zoom effects and so on, but I thought I would like to have something more creative with maybe a little bit more out of focus, tilt shift stuff. And let's see, maybe if I use this one, this might be nice, okay. Switch back to the beginning. You will see that the template is automatically added. Nothing to do, just taking over what you have done before. Including your titles. And I think I just need to get the audio a little bit down, otherwise it's too loud. Okay. Yeah, here you can see that you have a lot of nice out of focus effects, some nostalgic color effects and so on, which makes the whole thing look very nice. And we can also try another one, just to make sure that this might be the one I want to have. Maybe we can try the special My Pets one, because this is especially made for pets, yeah? So let's see. Okay, nice animated pets, and then the intro animation comes in. Okay. It moves the transitions in a different way, but it does not have this artificial old color look, so I like the other one better. Let's use the other one. And I think that should be okay. Okay, then this is what I want. Yeah. Yes, this looks really nice and cool. And I'm sure my grandma will like it. So basically my video is done, except that I still have to add also one clip to the final sequence, which is this one. It doesn't matter if you put it into the preview window or into the storyboard clip. You can do both, no problem. So, okay. Yeah. Now we are basically finished. Our slideshow, including video and photos, is done. Everything polished with music, with effects, with nice out of focus, old film effects and everything. That's really cool. The next thing I can do or could do is just export this as a file if I wanted to put it on an USB stick to play it on my TV set. But what I want to do, as I said before, is I want to create a DVD video. And for this purpose, I just click Next, Create a Disc, DVD, DVD Video, and it will load everything into the authoring part of Nero Video. And as you can see here, the video is already inserted. And I thought I don't only want to have this little slideshow video, I also want to have the original stuff, because maybe my grandma wants to see the whole stuff, so I also import the footage. Okay, trial version, we know it's limited in some aspects, but you can still use it, no problem. Okay, so this is the outdoor footage I want to add. And then it's added to the list of my assets. Yeah. And of course I can also switch the order of the assets inside of the project if I like to have a different order. Okay. Nothing else to do in this screen. The next thing would be to check the menus. Okay. So here you can see that this movie theme automatically takes over a matching menu, disk menu, with all the assets you have put into before. You can move the assets around. You can modify the title, and maybe you want to say for grandma. Oops, two. Okay. Put it here. The images you can put here. You can also change the wording if you want. We don't want to do this now, but we make it a little bit smaller, because this is not the most important stuff we have here. So this is your, these are your source footage assets. Okay. And this is the main movie. Maybe we do it like this, a little bit bigger. And then, of course, we can also change the text to my dogs. Oops, dogs. So, okay, my dogs. And, okay, this is the menu I want to use. I could also use a number of different menus. As you can see, we have action menus, we have smart 3D menus with complete animations, standard 2D menus with different topics, and we also have animated 2D menus, so you have a huge option of different styles that you like to do. But as I said, I like this one because it matches to the movie theme. So the next thing that you would need to do is check if your project performs on your DVD player the way it is meant to play. Okay, so basically this is the loudness control of your DVD player. Here you can see the selection, and if you click on the selected video, it will play. Yeah, okay, that's nice. Okay. Then let's see what happens with the next title. If I click next, what happens? Ah. Okay, it jumps back to the main menu. Ah, maybe that is not what I want. I would rather like to have each title play in sequence after each other. So I just go back. And here you have an option to customize. And inside of the customizing options, you have the disk project options. And in there you have a simple setting that says jump to menu, which we just saw. It is set like this right now. But if you click to play next title, then it will play each title in sequence. And this is what I want. You can also go to advanced editing and have a lot of more customization options. You can also create your very own templates and save them. But I don't want to do this now. If you like to go into more detail and get more experience, just try it out. It's really a cool tool for this purpose. So basically go to next. Here we are in our preview again. I click on my first title and then next title. That's what I want. Next title, okay. That's what I want, and this is my menu. Okay, basically I'm done. Now I just need to burn it. Okay, this is the final page before you go into the burning. Here you have to set your DVD recorder. You can also record as a disk image, for example, if you want to do that, and create your disk later if you want, for example with Nero Burning ROM. But right now we want to do real burning, and if I click on burn, it will burn. So we can see the progress now, creating the menus, transcoding the streams, and then I think we should be ready. Yes, so we are ready now. Basically, this is how it works. Very easy, very simple, and we hope that we could show you how easy it is to create a real great slideshow and a DVD with Nero Platinum 2018, even with the trial version. You can use it for 30 days, you can try out all of the features, and we hope you will do that and you will like it, and we hope you will join us next time. So have fun with Nero Platinum 2018.